Hello, everybody. It's time for the Binge Boys, episode 221. I'm your host, Logan, with Matt and Tanner.
Hello.
As always. Hello, friends.
Hi, how are we?
Solid. We also have host of the What Dern podcast is Griffin.
What Dern, y'all? What Dern, Matt?
Oh, that's an honor coming from you, sir. Thank you. I'm Dern well.
I'm Dern well. I've actually never heard that one. That's a good
I'm Dern
one.
Well. Dern well.
Okay, that's good, man. How you been Dern recently?
I've been good, man. Just crushing it. I'm in a new setup from when we recorded last. I'm in my home I own. I own it. It is mine.
Yes.
Made it to the new rig.
Really? Ooh. Nice. Big leagues.
Oh, yeah,
dude.
Big boy stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Shouts to Catherine for being in the background and choosing only to open up the loud packaging things when we started recording.
Booming loud. Catherine's okay. Diving into booming loud.
She is. She's big on booming and loud. Just kidding. That makes it sound like she's really into drugs. She's not. She is a teacher. She can't do that stuff. She probably wishes she could,
but nah.
Nope. Anyway.
This is awesome. Is this going on the YouTube?
Yeah, it's going to be awesome. On YouTube. Griffin, what kind of question is that? Dumb idiot.
I mean, sometimes some of the episodes don't go up.
They've been pretty consistently going up lately, unless intern Jackie's been slacking.
I don't know. Maybe I thought I didn't see a few.
Oh, well, yeah. We took a break for a while. Yeah.
Intern Jackie's been grinding.
She has been grinding.
I did see the little clips she was making. That's good shit.
She's been grinding. But if this is your first time at the Binge Boys podcast, welcome. If you're a returner listening, welcome back. If this is your first time, let me give you the rundown. The premise is that each week my co-host and I break down the hottest in TV and movies, as well as some music, video games, and pop culture here and there as well. Every Thursday, we have a bonus episode of the show entitled The Run Through. On those episodes, I'm joined by Tanner and Matt, Megan and Emily, or a combination of anybody and anyone who wants to dive into a different movie or TV series. I keep saying TV series. We've only done one TV series so far, and that was Dexter.
Sounds like you just need to do more. Just make it true.
True. Yeah. So we just need to throw another TV series on the rundown and just run through it. And we break it down element by element and give it an in-depth review. How can you tell us that you love us? First things first, follow us on Instagram at Binge Boys Podcast. That's where you get the announcements, the top five lists, the reviews, and so much more. Next, go into iTunes. Make sure you've left that 5-star rating and a short review. It helps us out a lot and helps us grow the program. Before we get into it, let's talk about a couple of our good buddies. Good buddy number one is Dazo. Dazo is the world's best spiked superfruit seltzer using gluten-free vodka and all-natural superfruits that are rich in electrolytes, antioxidants, and vitamins, replenishes you party. And always know exactly what you're putting inside your body. They're retailed throughout California and Massachusetts, but if you don't live in either of those states, you're in luck because you can go to drinkdazo.com, go to their store locator or area code finder or a comp or whatever it is, and you can punch in your zip code and you can see if Dazo is able to be shipped to you, no matter where you are in the continental United States. So, check them out. Drinkdazo.com. Find out if they can be brought to you. If you live in California or Massachusetts, then go to your local Total Wine, your liquor store, your wherever you get your booze, and see if you can find some Drink Dazo. You must be 21 years old or older to consume. And our other buddy, his name's Pearson. Have you heard of him? He might have been on the Binge Boys once or twice.
Prepped and ready.
Prepped and ready, guys. It's 2021 and everyone is on their hotness and fitness journey. And one of the biggest aspects of that lifestyle is eating healthy and meal prepping. The problem is that most people have no idea where to start and are overwhelmed by the amounts of options. And they don't know what meals suit them best for the goals they want to achieve. Luckily, Prepped and Ready has that solution for you. Prepped and Ready Meals delivers high quality, fresh meals with health, and fitness in mind. With a variety of healthy, low-calorie, but delicious meals, we can cater to anyone's personal needs. If you live in the greater Atlanta, Georgia area and you're interested in meal prep made simple, you can go to PreppedReadyMeals.com and you can use a code BINGE15 at checkout for for 15% off your first time order. BINGE15 at checkout, 15% off your order. Prepped Ready Meals, meal prep made simple.
Hell yeah.
That's as easy as it gets right there.
It sure is. Matt, what'd you get into this weekend?
It was my sister's 30th birthday, so big ups to Mal. Had a weekend on the lake, so plenty of water time, and can tell partially by my lighting, got some sun on my face here. So today was a little bit rough getting back to the work life, but hey man, it was a good time. Just lots of good family time. So yeah, man, what's going on over there? Did y'all get into much?
Well, Friday night I worked. Sunday all day I worked, but Saturday was a movie. Catherine and I made a big, big boy, but she is a female. We made an adult purchase or adult decision the other day. And we got a Costco membership.
There it is.
So we invested in Costco. Shouts to Bob for signing us up, but also for trying to upsell us in every way possible. Like, dude, Bob, we know what membership we want.
He's trying to give you the gift of Costco.
Well, we did our research and we knew what gift we wanted at Costco. And he's like, have you heard about our Gold Premium Plus member pack? And we're like, yes, Bob. I know what membership I want. Just sign me up for the damn gold one. But that didn't stop him for about 20 minutes of telling us how amazing the Costco credit card is and how much money he has saved on it. Shouts to Bob. He'd been at Costco for 21 years, I think it was. He'd been there since 1999. So he'd been there almost 22 years. So shouts to Bob.
Damn.
He was
Bobby Grinds over there.
Costco veteran, man.
Yeah, really, though. So shouts to Bob. But yeah, we got Costco membership. We were on a little bit of a time crunch. We ran a lot of errands on Saturday, but I want to go back this weekend if possible and just walk around for like 4 hours and just see the ins and outs of Costco.
That's a bad idea. And you're going to get lured into buying an unnecessary thing.
Yeah, well, we have bought a toaster. I can confirm that a toaster has been purchased, mainly because Catherine's been begging for us to get a toaster. And I keep saying the fun word that I say to everything that she wants now. I just say registry. And it usually gets her to stop asking for a few minutes. But she said, I don't want to go a year and a half without a toaster.
Yeah, you can't use the oven. You can't use the oven to toast.
So, no, we can't. And you definitely shouldn't try to use the microwave to toast.
only steaks only in the microwave.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, we got a toaster. Shouts to Catherine. It's also shouts to Catherine. You're listening to this Tuesday. Wednesday is her 26th birthday.
There it is. Big ups.
Big ups to Bay. Be on the lookout for a special edition of the run through coming out later in August with her favorite movie, Dirty Dancing.
Dude, time of my life.
Absolutely. Shouts to Patrick Swayze. So,
Roadhouse.
Exactly. Roadhouse. So yeah, we kind of just did that. We had a little pool situation go on Saturday afternoon before it rained and it kind of shoot us out of there. Couple of our close friends came down and we just kind of mobbed at the pool for like 3 hours. And then it started raining and that was kind of a buzzkill. We had to get out of there pretty fast. It started pouring. So shouts to everyone who came to our little pool situation to celebrate Catherine on Saturday. But other than that, what did we do Saturday night? Oh, we went to the brewery in downtown Kennesaw. Shouts to Horned Owl. A lot of shout outs. They're not paying me. Yes, I did talk to their people on Saturday, so we'll see. But yeah, man, I think that's all I got into. Tanner, what'd you get yourself into?
Well, Friday, I got up and I went to work.
It's the same thing with you.
My boss quit that day on the spot, left Mitch.
Dang.
And then the next kid quit who was supposed to come in at 2 for relief also. So now we have a total of 4 people working at Little Caesars with our other manager, like our above manager, and my, like, the owner. I'm going to work with the owner. I'm going to close with him.
Oh,
like, what the hell? I don't want
to
do that.
You hate to close with the owner.
But then Saturday.
More importantly, the owner hates to close with you.
Oh, yeah.
No offense, but the last thing the owner wants to do is be there at 10 o'clock at night on a Tuesday.
He's got kids, yeah.
Yeah, oh, he's probably got a family, probably got a life. If he's the owner, I assume maybe he owns multiple locations.
He does.
Okay.
He's a good guy.
Is he like the district or the area manager? He owns like 2 or 3 stores or something? Manager.
He is the he owns all of that. All of
is
them.
It in fact Caesar himself?
I think so.
Are you as little as they say?
Yeah, but well, Saturday. Saturday I got up, worked. Yep. Sunday I got up, worked.
What'd you do today?
What got up, worked. I hate that
story. A lot going on with Tanner, right?
And now I hate it even more because there's 4 people there.
Yeah.
And I get to do double the amount of work and it's awesome. And it's so much fun. I can't wait to go back tomorrow.
Griffin, what'd you get into this weekend?
Oh, I binged a lot. I didn't have anything going on. I'm done working, so I was binging.
What'd you binge?
Last
night. I binged Kung Fu Panda 1, 2, and 3. I'd say they're smack.
Catch a run through coming soon, maybe with Kung Fu Panda.
It's so good, man. I love
Kung the run through that no one's asking for.
It's so good, though. I loved it. I ate up every bit of it. But yeah, that was fun. I watched Step Brothers. That was fun. It's always good to see Will Ferrell. He's just a fucking blast.
Yeah.
What else? Laid out by the pool, got some sun with my sister. We watched Ted as well.
Ooh. Sneaky shouts to the run through that's coming out in a couple weeks. Ted.
Yeah.
Dude, this is just the run through scheduling.
Yeah. Run-through's going crazy. I'm even planning 2022 run-throughs right now.
It's a lot of run-through.
Mainly trying to line up some of the run-through releases with like some sequels that are coming out around that time of next year. Like next summer when the new Jurassic World comes out, we're going to do a run-through of the sequel to the original Jurassic Park, The Lost World. I think there's a Pixar movie that's scheduled to come out next summer. I think it was that red one. What is it?
Red Panda or something.
Yeah, something like that. Either way, I think we're going to do a run through for Toy Story 2 that same weekend. Kind of lining things up. I think there's another sequel to the Fantastic Beasts movie that's supposed to drop next summer. So we're going to do a run through of Sorcerer's Stone.
And where
The OG Harry Potter. I don't know who I'm going to do that one with yet because...
I know my last name, right?
Oh, true. And I'm pretty sure the contact picture for you in my phone is you holding a magic wand in Harry Potter world.
Dude, you know it.
All right, bet. So I've just figured out my co-host for that run through. Well, aside from creepy laughs from Griffin, we're going to dive right into the headlines. Got some nothing super crazy, just a few kind of announcements more than anything. Tanner's looking at me like I'm forgetting something.
No, I'm saying you got to. I'm just.
Looking, no, you're just looking at me.
Yeah, looking in excitement.
Eagerness.
This one, yes. I'm not surprised about. Star Wars: The Bad Batch has been renewed for a second season by Disney Plus.
Star Wars: The Bad
Bitch. The bad.
You cannot call it the bad bitch.
Who is the bad bitch? That's in what Star I Wars. You got to think it's Princess Leia.
Ahsoka Tano.
Yeah, most definitely.
Ahsoka Tano.
Who else that Ahsoka Tano button?
Bro, Q Mitch saying Ahsoka Tano.
Tano. Ahsoka Tano. Ahsoka Tano.
So there's Q Mitch shouts to, dude, what about sports? Dude, I had this fear, actually this realization the other day that like, what if Watchdog Media becomes so convoluted with other podcasts and other personalities that it's almost like the MCU of podcasting. Like you can't get through one episode of one pod without another pod being referenced or another host or another somebody.
It's pretty fun though.
People are saying Watchdog is the MCU of podcasting.
I think that's, there we go. We got the branding down.
We do. Yes. We do.
We do. And we have variety.
All right, Griff.
We have sports.
We do have sports. What the MCU doesn't have, dude, sports.
Hell no.
MCU doesn't have sports, so we're ahead of them on that one. It says that Disney announced that Lucasfilm's next animated series, The Bad Batch, is returning in 2022. There's no date or anything. The finale, that is not a correct date. I think that's a typo. These people need to fix their typo. It says that the season finale airs this coming Wednesday, April 11th, but a lot of people that are listening know that this Wednesday is, in fact, August 11th.
So that's not evergreen, but yes, it is.
Shouts to Flickering Myth, which is just an all-time bad website name. They need to fix their typo.
Yeah.
But But that's basically that. That's that headline. Speaking of next seasons,
have you
go ahead?
Oh, I was just gonna say, have you continued to keep up with the Bad Batch, or you're just out, just too mediocre?
Just too mediocre. Very much so. Just
boring.
Boring.
Not interested.
Not interested.
Yeah. Bam, bam. All of bam, the bam, above. Bam, bam,
bam. Don't really care. Did you even watch it from the get go? Did you try?
No.
I didn't think so.
I didn't watch Clone Wars, and that's kind of what the spinoff is from, right? Yeah. So
I will say Clone Wars is awesome. You should definitely watch that one.
It's on the list for sure.
But Bad Batch is just bad. I mean, it's not bad. It's just cartoonish.
But it's not bad. It is a cartoon. It's cartoony. Yeah, it's just
I'm not finding the words to say tonight, but like it's just not gripping. It's not like a Mandalorian where they're gonna keep you coming back.
I just don't want to watch it. Like I should want to, you know.
It feels like a tough to watch.
I should want to.
You should be pumped for this.
Yes, I should be pumped every Friday for the episode to drop.
I honestly forget that it even exists still currently until you mentioned it.
Yeah,
that's so fun.
So it is what it is. But speaking of another season that's dropping, Cobra Kai. They dropped a trailer for Cobra Kai season 4 to come out on Netflix in this December.
Ooh.
How about that? None of you watch Cobra Kai. Am I correct on that?
None.
You are correct.
Correct.
I actually watched a little bit of the first season, but I didn't really get into it that much.
Yeah, it's shouts to Jordan, because there's nobody on planet Earth more excited for Cobra Kai season 4 than Jordan is. That's basically
another MCU character. There we go.
Yep, there you go. Absolutely. Jordan is so excited. So shouts to Jordan on being excited.
It's a good one. A lot of people are going to be ready for that one.
Yeah, you should also keep the microphone close when you talk.
Sorry.
You're good. This was big. Yeah. I was very intrigued when I saw this. The creators of South Park signed a huge mega deal with CBS that gave them about $900 million. Almost a billy. They are expanding the South Park universe.
What?
The creatives are South Park signed a new deal with CBS, Viacom CBS, which are the people behind Paramount Plus. They are going to be developing several spinoff movies and shows that are all going to debut first on Paramount Plus.
South Park.
Hell yes. I sneaky like South Park, but I also don't care about South Park.
I never watch it.
I love South Park. It's great.
I love South Park, but also don't care about South Park. You know?
It's pretty immature.
Yeah. I like the episodes of South Park that were released.
You're a turtle.
That were released from between I was 16 and 21, and anything else is just unwatchable garbage to me.
It is really hard to... If you're a little more of a mature audience, it's not aimed for the mature audience at all. I would say if you're an adult, it's meant for adults, but it's just not.
Says here specifically, they are going to be developing 14 made for streaming movies. So 14 movies will debut on Paramount Plus first.
I don't know.
Over the next 7 years, it says up through 2027.
You have to think that's too many movies.
Yeah, you got to think that that's a lot of South Park.
Yeah, that's going to be a lot of content.
Sounds like oversaturation.
Yeah. Almost. Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. I was like, they might overdo this a little bit.
Yeah, well.
We'll see.
Only time will tell. No dates again. Just kind of an announcement that it's happening. So.
Still cool for the South Park fans, though.
Yeah, I mean, if you're a diehard South Park fan, you're gonna be jumping for joy on this.
Oh yeah.
Hopefully, you don't age out of it by the time the movie comes out.
For real. 7 years.
7 years from now.
Goodness.
How old will you be in 7 years, God. Griffin? You'll be 28. Holy shit! I'll be like 35. Well, I can't do math. I'll be 32. Gosh.
And you know what's funny? 8 years ago felt like yesterday. That's the scary part.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway.
Next headline here. Last headline, actually. It says here, James Gunn is not done with DC after the Suicide Squad.
Thank God.
He says he in an interview with Entertainment Tonight, he said that when talking about what are you talking about right now?
Sorry.
In an interview with Entertainment Tonight, when asked about a sequel to the Suicide Squad or spinoffs with a smaller characters, he said, "I am nowhere done with villainverse yet."
Okay.
So it sounds like DC was very confident.
I was excited about that.
Was very confident in James Gunn in his abilities to perform. And there you go. They're confident in him. So we're going to see some shit from James Gunn going forward with DC and Marvel, it sounds like.
Cool. I'm for it.
Yeah, it's good that I'm curious if like anywhere in any contracts DC or Disney has been like, or Warner Brothers or Disney has been like, hey, if you sign here, this says you can't make any movies for our direct competitor.
The non-compete
And clause, he probably told him to fuck off, honestly. Probably,
yeah.
He probably told him to fuck off because can't be doing that.
And wasn't it originally because they didn't? What, I forgot why. Because
Marvel fired him, fired him because of those tweets from like 10 years ago,
right.
And then DC were like, "We'll take him."
Yeah, and he did well.
Yep.
Extremely.
And now comeback story. And now Disney gets him back because they feel bad
and need him.
And then they see the success of the Suicide Squad. So.
Oh man, yeah.
James Gunn is going to be sitting pretty for a minute. So we can just transition right in to the Suicide Squad. Let me read you some information and what is probably about to be a really bad synopsis from IMDb, but it's a bit at this point, so we're just going to go with it. So let's see. The Suicide Squad. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Not a horrible synopsis. It says supervillains Harley Quinn, Bloodsport, Peacemaker, and a collection of nutty cons at the prison join the super secret, super shady Task Force X as they are dropped off in the remote enemy infused island of Corta Maltese to combat a mysterious project. It's not horrible. That's pretty good on the spectrum of IMDb synopsis.
Yeah.
Synopses. Is that the plural of synopsis?
Yes.
Didn't know
synopsis. There was a plural.
Okay, bet. Yes. Love that. The movie clocks in around 2 hours and 12 minutes. It is rated R, directed and written by James Gunn, as we just said, starring Margot Robbie, Idris Elba, Joel Kinnaman, John Cena, Michael Rooker, Viola Davis, Jai Courtney, Pete Davidson, Sean Gunn, Sylvester Stallone, and the list
all recognizable
goes
names.
On and on. All recognizable names, exactly. Matt.
So
you scored the Suicide Squad, I think, the lowest out of the four of us. What are your thoughts on the Suicide Squad? Did you see the original Suicide Squad without the? And what was your experience? Did you go to the theaters? Did you watch it at home? Give us the rundown.
So I did not watch Suicide Squad, but I did watch Guardians of the Galaxy in 2014. So I feel like I had seen this movie already. I watched it at home on HBO Max. just kind of on yesterday afternoon. I didn't, like I said, I didn't dislike it because I enjoyed the original Guardians of the Galaxy, but that's kind of why it's just a 3 out of 5. I feel like it was pretty much a retread, just maybe with a little bit more swearing and gore.
Mm.
That's fair, yeah.
It is fair.
It is.
I mean, I'm pretty sure when we all heard that James Gunn was going to do a Suicide Squad, it's going to be like, oh, so he's just going to make an R-rated Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah.
Or an R-rated Avengers movie, essentially.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So was there any specific point that you wished was better that would have maybe given you a 4 out of 5 or a 5 out of 5? Or was it just across the board, like, just entertaining, but you never are going to watch this movie again?
That's kind of where I'm at. I think like there's a lot. I think so. There's sort of like counterpoints. I thought the plot twist with Peacemaker was kind of forced and out of nowhere, just for the sake of there being like a plot twist. So that's kind of a negative. Totally. But then like a positive, I like that they sort of steered into just DC sort of back catalog of really weird characters like TDK and Polka Dot Man and
yeah.
Like you gotta think like 3D Man's gonna make an appearance in at some point in the future. I can go on and on. I know a lot, or I'm blanking now, but I definitely know some rare characters. Also, I just checked that 3D Man is Marvel, so didn't even get through that statement without messing it up. So
damn.
But yeah, what's up?
I was just wondering, what did TDK stand for? But wasn't it the detachable kid?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
He could, like,
it was really silly. I did like that fake out at the beginning. That was pretty fun.
That was fun.
In the trailers, they made that scene look like it was almost like a really, really big, like third act fight. But the fact that they like kind of started off and they went straight to the island, I was like, okay, so we're getting right into this. Like,
I know. I was like,
totally, yeah.
Okay.
And yeah, you said I was just gonna say you'd said you haven't seen the original Suicide Squad, right?
That is correct. I did not see that.
Okay. Me neither, Matt.
Okay.
Yeah. Tanner,
have you seen the OG Suicide Squad?
I didn't have any idea what it will. I didn't have any idea who the characters, plot, or cast, anybody. I didn't have any idea.
Well, this is one of those rare sequels / reboot / redo movies, because a few points in the movie they acknowledged the fact that the other Suicide Squad happened.
I think it did still happen.
But this was like DC's way of like kind of pushing that one like under the bed. Like, hey, that never happened. It still is in our universe, but it never happened. So Tanner, I want to ask you, because you gave it the best score. You gave it a 5 out of 5. You absolutely loved this movie.
I enjoyed every second of it. It was awesome. I did not expect that. I was worried until like right at the beginning, you know, as you said, they hopped right into it. And after seeing the first one was compared to this.
I was going
to
say
so much. The gore was awesome. King Shark was sharp. King Shark was dope. The starfish was dope. It was all awesome.
So in comparison to the first movie, because me and you have seen the OG, I guess, Suicide Squad. What do you think's the biggest difference between this one and that one? Because I've got mine right off the bat. I think
the whole plot, the fact that they were out of the city, the whole plot. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's just it.
I think this movie also takes itself way less serious.
Yeah, true.
Like the first one was very much so trying to be this gritty, dark, like we're in the DC universe, so we're going to have villains that have horrifying backstories. And and the first one, they threw the Jared Leto's Joker in there to try to like start that spinoff. It was just kind of, I really want to do, it'd be fun to do a run through of the OG Suicide Squad.
I'd do that.
Just because
I'd be down,
because I own it. It's not horrifyingly bad, like a lot of people say it is, but it is objectively probably the worst movie DC has. I mean, it's,
well,
stop it.
What do you have?
He thinks Batman versus Superman is the worst DC movie there is.
That's an argument.
Watch.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm going to do it. We're going to force you to watch the OG Suicide Squad, and we're going to do a run through for it. Mark my words. Yeah, you too. Everybody who hasn't seen it, we'll do it us four again, and we'll revisit this in like a few months or something.
Sure, sure.
But yeah, the OG Suicide Squad was very like just but there are things that I did like. I did like Joker in Suicide Squad, but they did force him and they really tried to force that Harley and Joker narrative on you. Mm-hmm. Where I liked Harley by herself here. Where she like didn't have to piggyback after off of like Joker,
Mr. J.
Because I think she's awesome. Margot Robbie's great.
So much to do. Just a ton to do.
I think really like that. I think that Margot Robbie is probably one of the best castings that DC has as Harley Quinn, and Will Smith in the OG is good, but. Him and Idris Elba do not play the same character. Because at first they were going to recast Idris Elba as Will Smith, but for some reason, I think it said something in Will Smith's contract that nobody will play Deadshot for a period of time. So they replaced that character with Bloodsport.
Yeah, I've never heard of him.
Yeah, I had neither.
Which, different. An assassin who can kill with any weapon and is skilled at hand-to-hand combat. I did like how they poked fun about that with Idris Elba and John Cena, that their characters were basically the same.
Yeah.
I gave it a 4 out of 5. I landed right in between you guys. I was genuinely surprised about how much I think a movie like that needed to be rated R. I don't know if it would have worked as PG-13.
Agreed.
It wouldn't have.
No.
It would have been a little bit.
I'll say that my three favorite pieces of the movie were Polka Dot Man, King Shark, and John Cena. I really liked John Cena in this.
He did play a good acting role.
Freaking funny
He's been proving himself a little more piece by piece over the last few years that he can be in movies too, kind of like following The Rock. Mm-hmm. And all of the other Dave Bautista, all the other wrestlers that have become actors. Like I enjoy the Suicide Squad. I thought it was really funny. I think there were several moments that I laughed out loud.
I gave it a 4 out of 5 too. So
yeah,
I thought it was amazing.
Oh yeah. I laughed out loud. I like this.
And you watched it at home as well, Tanner, didn't you?
Yeah. And it was,
me and Logan watched in theater.
Yeah. We saw it in the theaters.
It was wonderful.
Good experience. In theaters.
Oh, it was, we were right in the middle, perfect seats.
And that probably added to the fact that I liked it as much. If I watched it at home, I might have given it a 3 out of 5.
Totally.
Really?
I don't know. I
didn't expect that.
I didn't expect to love a lot of the characters, and that's where the first Suicide Squad went wrong, where like they didn't give you much anything about the characters. They just said, here's a bunch of really, really bad people. We're going to send them to do a really, really good thing, and that's it.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, that movie walked so this one could run.
Yeah, I think they kind of had to get this bad one out of the chamber before they could make something better.
Mainly though, because like this movie starts out like we said earlier, and they get right into it. Like they, you know, you see the scene where they go into Michael Rooker's cell. They grab him. She quickly explains, like, there's a bomb in the back of your head. If you disobey my orders, I blow you to smithereens.
Oh, yeah.
And then it cuts immediately to, like, them getting on the helicopter. Yeah. Like, in the first movie, there was, like, 30 minutes of them explaining, like, these people are the worst of the worst. They're in this super prison. We're going to take them. We're going to make them do good. We're going to knock some years off their sentence. Like, they really dove deep into that. But this movie, I think, is counting on the fact that we know by now because we saw that first one. So that's why they got immediately into it.
And I think sort of that initial scene might have like unfairly set my expectations that it was just going to be nonstop. And then when it sort of couldn't keep that same like frenetic pace, when I had to do character work and other stuff, it just felt like it was kind of like dragging. Like I found myself like checking my phone, like when they were, you know, just first like milling around like Jotunheim and stuff like that. So
yeah,
the Jotunheim.
One. I think the also just like the characters in the first one were just less likable.
Sure.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Killer 100%. Croc was in the first one, and Killer Croc's one of my favorite Batman villains. And he was just unmemorable.
Boring. I forgot he was in it.
Damn. Completely forgot until I just brought it up.
Like, that's upsetting.
And I think King Shark here was supposed King Shark. I made that joke the other night, and Catherine just started laughing real hard in the kitchen because I said, "Yeah, King Shark was awesome," and she's like, "King Shark." I think he's meant to be like the Groot. Yeah. Like the stupid character of the group.
Just the one that doesn't make sense at all.
Yeah, yeah, totally. Absolutely. And I love that they don't give you next to no backstory about King Shark. Like, yep. He's just a walking, talking shark, and everyone just goes along with it.
Yeah. Everybody accepts him.
Yeah, and I think that, like, this is just kind of like a larger, like, commentary on, like, superhero movies. Like, trust the audience. They'll go along with it if you just say, like, this is how it is, and the other characters are, like, okay with it. Like,
yeah,
just do it.
Yeah. We'll accept it. Yeah, it'll be fun.
You don't have to, like, hammer in why it's important that King Shark is a shark. Like, you just,
and
like,
why he's there. It's
like, put a walking, talking shark on screen and have him say funny things here and there, and people are going to go along with it.
Oh, yeah. Totally. I laughed a lot at that shark. I thought it was a good one. That's Sylvester, right?
Yeah, that was Sly Stone.
Yeah, that was good.
Alone. He has no reason to rip that guy in half with his hands. Why did he do that?
That was good.
Like that.
They get pretty graphic.
That was gore for the reason that it's rated R, and they're like, well, we can do it.
Oh yeah.
So well, I think it got the rated R when it literally showed the shard of like ceramic or whatever go into Flag's heart.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, totally.
Remember when they shot the bullet at each other and it went through the other one?
That was cool.
That was dope.
Or right at the beginning when Pete Davidson's
I thought it was just cool.
Blown off.
There's a lot of cool epic action scenes. It was just fun movie.
I think Turner was sitting next to me during the movie and he likes Pete Davidson's stand up.
Yeah.
And he was like, "Oh my god, Pete Davidson this? Davidson's is in this? I'm on board." And like 5 minutes later his face literally gets blown off. And he just looks at me and he's like, "I'm officially out on this movie."
Yeah. Yeah, there's some epic tickets out of the box office out of this movie.
There's some really good
gory ones.
Really good death scenes here for some characters. Like, what'd you think of the weasel, Matt?
I'm not a weasel guy. I'm sorry.
Not a big weasel guy, played by James Gunn's brother, Sean Gunn. That was him in CGI.
Really?
And Mora Cross. Marvel thing. Taika Waititi was Ratmaster 1.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's another cameo later on. It was a very quick scene, but somebody pointed it out to me afterwards that in the scene where the group goes into the bar to try to get what's his name? The Brainiac guy.
Yeah, yeah.
One of the bartenders is Palm. I don't know how to say her last name, but she's the woman that plays Mantis.
Oh, okay, okay. Clement.
Yeah, that. Yeah, yeah. She is. She's one of the bartenders.
You heard that?
Okay.
Yeah, I heard it. I said Palm, and Tanner goes a granite. It's like that video. Have you seen that Family Feud?
I think it's hilarious.
Video.
Oh yeah.
Where the guy is just like, name something that follows pork, and the guy's like, you pine.
Steve Harvey just like disassociates in that minute.
It's one of those moments where Steve Harvey just like looks at the camera and is like, why am I here?
Ooh, now that's
what's
a good
my
question.
Purpose.
Steve Harvey net worth.
Ooh,
200 mil.
Oh, that's, I think that's low.
Yeah, 200 mil. So I'm firm on that.
What do you think? What do you think, Tanner? What's Steve Harvey's net worth?
200 million. 275 million. He's above that.
What do you got, Logan?
I have no idea.
Oh,
I just heard you say
it is. It's a tough.
Should I do Prices Right and just go $1? No. Oh,
God, don't be that guy.
Real guess.
I'm going to go. Are you looking at it right now?
I'm looking at it right this second.
Perfect.
I'm going to go 300 mil. I think he's worth a lot more than we think.
Okay, well, I think Griffin looked this up earlier because it is exactly 200 million.
Wow. Yeah, no, I swear to God, I didn't do
that. Griffin just saw into the future and was just like, we're going to talk about Steve Harvey on this episode of The Binge Boys.
Well, I mean, he's got his own show, but other than that, like, what else is Steve Harvey doing?
I don't know.
He's got his own line of suits.
Yeah. Oh, okay, really? Nice. Yeah. Okay, that's why he's always dappered up.
Yeah.
Understood. With
like seven buttons.
Oh yeah, he's got the little pocket square too. He's got it all.
I thought he had. Did he have a talk show as well?
Probably.
He had an interview show, a talk show at some point a few years ago. I don't know if he still does it, but he used to. Because I remember seeing.
I wasn't around for that. Or maybe
he just filled in for like Oprah whenever she was out, because he had a very similar setup to her classic setup. So maybe he was just filling in for her, but. I think Oprah's asking somebody more esteemed than Steve Harvey to fill in on the Oprah Winfrey show.
She doesn't want a king of comedy on her show?
No, I don't know. I don't know. back to the Suicide
Squad. Yeah.
Good movie.
Yeah.
Ooh,
I'd still say it was a good movie. I enjoyed it.
Side note, I'm going to look this one up just because we usually do these in twos. Sylvester Stallone's net worth. That's a tough one.
That is tough.
This Dude is a trick question in a way.
$750 million.
No, that's too much.
No. That's not too low.
That's too much, I said.
Oh, okay, okay.
Okay.
I've got it. $1 billion.
No, absolutely not.
No.
What do you think, Tanner, realistically? What you got?
That was realistically. But $300 million.
Okay. Griffin?
$150 mil. He's Rambo. He's old money.
Rambo, that's true. Rocko.
He's got a point. He is old money. Matt, totally. What you got?
He's got his houses now.
225. Yeah, just a bit more than Steve Harvey.
He's actually closer to the half a billion mark. He's at about 400 million.
Yeah, Rambo, damn. Everything.
Yeah, he's one of the biggest action stars of all time.
Rocky, Rambo, what else?
Okay, yeah. I didn't notice that. I didn't watch them.
He's in Guardians. I didn't think he'd get the bag like that.
You got to think James Gunn paid him 100 mil to be King Shark. I want to know how much he got paid now to be like what, like 17 lines? And all of them were just like... friends
or stupid shit.
How much do you think Vin Diesel got paid to just say I am Groot like 30,000 different ways?
That's true. Let's find out. How much did Vin Diesel get paid? Why don't I just voice it as I'm saying it on the pod? How much did Vin Diesel get paid to be Groot? Oh, it's the first suggestion. He got paid about $54.5 million.
What?
Dang.
Just to say I am
Groot. That's like $20 million bucks a word.
Just to say I am Groot.
I am Groot.
I am Groot.
Well, that's cool.
That is neat.
So yeah, I guess Suicide Squad. I'm gonna get on and maybe show Catherine some of the better scenes, because I'm curious what she thought. I laughed out loud that first night where they're at the campfire and they wake up and King Shark's just like holding her up, like lowering her into the mount.
That was good.
And she's just like, you wouldn't eat your friends. And he's like, I have no friends.
She's like, dude, be my friend. We don't want you to eat us.
All of this. You know what? I'm going to say it. King Shark. I need a series. I need a prequel. I need something. I want more.
Give me more Shark.
Give me more King Shark. Give me more Polka Dot Man. Yeah. I was really... very intrigued by that guy.
What's that guy's name?
I don't know his name, but he's in The Dark Knight.
He was that.
He was the crazy guy that Harvey Dent like put in the alleyway. Oh, was just like.
He was in the cop car, right?
Yeah, he was like, I don't know anything. He's like, I swear.
He's like crying in the back seat. Remember?
Swear to me.
It was when the Joker was out. During the march and shot up in the air and everything went to hell.
David Dasmalchian.
That's a name.
I did not.
Definitely not American.
What a guy.
He could be American.
No, I doubt it. He doesn't look American.
He was born in Kansas. What's more American than that?
You serious?
Yes.
Damn. Shouts to that guy. We're going to get him on the pod and he's going to slander me for.
He's going to slander me now. Damn.
Yeah, for real.
Shit. I'm sorry, bro.
So
we'd like to have you on the pod.
That's Suicide Squad, man. If you like it, if you like superhero movies, go see it. If you are not sure about it, watch it at home for free on HBO Max.
I'd recommend.
It's a fun time. It's a fun movie. But if you Griffin said it perfectly though when we left the movie, he said there are gonna be some movie people that don't like that movie. Like
totally.
That's a weird. It was a weird movie.
Yeah.
And it uses weird characters that ultimately, besides maybe Harley Quinn, no one really gives a shit about.
I'd say
except for now, me being King Shark's number one fan.
Yeah, you're saying there's no Rick Flag heads out there?
I don't think there is. I don't think there's Peacemaker any Polka Dot stands. Man stands.
The thing is this doesn't really appeal to that hardcore action, like non-CGI kind of hardcore Batman-ish encounters. Yeah. But this is more of a CGI paradise.
Although,
you know,
our mom... I don't know about your mom, Tanner. I'm going to assume she does. Your mom likes Guardians of the Galaxy, loves doesn't it. She? Loves my it. Mom did too. I don't know if my mom's going to love this movie.
No, my mom's
going to yeah, like they're going to be like, what the hell?
My mom likes the actor for Rick Flag, but she's going to...
Joel Kinnaman.
I like him.
I like him too. He's good. He's in For All Mankind.
How sad.
Yeah, and that's another fun thing is a lot of the characters that were transferred over from the OG Suicide Squad got murked in the Boomerang first, like Captain Boomerang got murked.
Wait, what happened to him? Refresh me.
Didn't he throw the boomerang and it come back around and kill him himself? No,
he was holding on to it though, and he got blown up or some fire.
Like that helicopter that.
Oh, that's it. There we go. That's he got.
Yeah, that was bad.
He got cut in.
That was very bad.
Like somebody's getting either arrested or killed
or murked, like that one dude.
Yeah. Oh, what about the spear guy?
Oh,
we're talking about spear guy.
Javelin.
Oh, Javelin. Yeah.
I love how she was like, I love your accent. He was like, she was like, I love your accent. And he just said, like most American girls do, which is funny because it's true.
Huh?
Most American girls love accents. Fuck, I love accents. They're cool. I wish I had an accent.
Someone's calling me.
Someone called you. Forrest Gump.
Answer on the
pod. Do not answer it.
Yeah, no.
Forrest didn't come through for me.
What do you mean?
Griffin knows what that means. That's all I'll say. Suicide Squad, check it out, HBO Max or in theaters.
Yeah, it's a good one.
So for this segment, we would be reviewing Donda for Kanye West, but Tanner was right. He didn't drop the damn album.
And you won't this week either.
No, I haven't heard any chatter about it.
I think too many. The thing the reveal has too many features. They're not going to get cleared by this week.
Oh, is that why? I did see the list of features, and I was like, "Holy shit!"
It's dark fantasy tier features. Yeah.
Have you seen this, Tanner?
No.
There's some pretty good.
Let me read
notable names up on that. Bitch.
Let me read you off the.
I was surprised when I saw the. I was like, "Gosh, the list goes."
Yep.
There's going to be a banger in there that everybody's going to be listening to.
Of course.
One song. There's got to be one.
All right. Tanner, are you ready?
Nothing's really hitting right now.
All right. The list of features includes Pusha T, Don Toliver, Kid Cudi, Fivo Foreign, Donda, which is apparently an artist, Lil Yachty, Playboi Carti, Travis Scott, Baby Keem, Young Thug, Roddy Ricch, Lil Durk, and then a bunch of randoms, Lil Baby, The Weeknd, Pop Smoke, Jay-Z, and several more, The Sunday Service Choir, Francis and the Lights, and many, many more.
This might slap.
Those were just the most notable. But how many songs are on this thing? Is this a double album? Is there only... Because there's no way this is going to be like a DJ Khaled album.
No,
and it'd be
no.
like 10 songs and each song has 5 features.
No.
Well, no, because Kanye actually does the work and like produces.
Yeah, DJ Khaled is just in the background just dancing while his producer is like actually making the beat. DJ Khaled is just the mascot of the operation. There's no
DJ
way
Khaled is the kid on the group project who just puts his name on it when it comes in the day of. He's like, oh man, I couldn't meet.
Khaled's the guy who they hire to do no work for the project, but just be the guy who presents because everyone else is too shy.
Yeah.
Khaled gets up in front and like BS's it because he doesn't know what the project's about. He's like, rocks.
Another one.
Next slide.
We the best.
So instead of reviewing Donda, we just put together a list. Haven't done a top 5 list in a while. Of some artists besides Kanye. I left Kanye off my list because it's almost a given. If you guys have him on your list, that's cool. But I just left him off considering he is not come through for me this year. So I'm not going to come through with him and put him on my list. I know that's going to be really upsetting to him.
Suck it,
not being on Logan Lewis's Binge Boy podcast list. But So some artists that we would really love for them to drop an album this year, or really early next year, or whatever, really. Just an artist that we would love to drop an album. I'll start. You guys know how the drill goes. I'll start. We'll go me, Griffin, Tanner, and then Matt, and then we will, you know, don't need to spend too much time, maybe just a little sentence or two here or there for each person, but then we'll just move on, or otherwise we'll be here forever.
Ever.
All right. I'll start. My list is odd. I'll say that straight up.
Me as well.
I have two artists on here that people are going to be like, what? But the other three, I think, are predicted. My number one is, or not number one, number five is Sam Hunt. Sam Hunt got album of the year for me a few years ago with his last album. That was like 2019, I believe. And I really want some more. That's really it. I just want some more. So, Griffin, are you breathing into that thing? I'm not. Okay.
I don't hear it.
Okay, good. I looked down at the little levels and I saw his skyrocketing, but that was probably just mine. So, yeah, that's who I got. I got Sam Hunt. We'll see if he drops something. Doubt it. He hasn't even put a single out and it's August. So unless he pulls a, I don't know, like a Gunna and releases a single on Thursday and says, oh, yeah, the album's coming out Friday. It's like, oh, okay. Thanks for the
update.
The pub and the update. Yeah, Griffin. Who is your number five?
Number five for me is Young Bands.
Young Bands is good.
If you've heard Young Bands, probably. You might not have, though. He's kind of low-key. Not a lot of people know about him. But
willing to bet that Matt has never heard Young Bands.
No way.
And I have my eyes wide.
He's probably not heard three out of five. He's good, man. A few of his songs just match my vibe, all sort right. of. He's pretty chill, dude.
Young Bands.
I hope he comes out with something.
You think Young Bands will make them dance? Oh, oh.
All right. My number five is 42 Doug.
Oh, yeah. That's yes. a good one.
I don't know. He's new, so, you know, let's hear some stuff. Isn't he's newer? Good, I mean, to me, he, I just discovered
I don't think
him,
42
so
Doug
more.
Is new. Okay.
So I want to
You
want to
know
a
fun fact is he's not new. I met 42 Probably. Doug the other night.
You did?
At pizza.
You did not.
I did. But I did meet his manager.
Really?
Well, no. I lied again. I met Lil Baby's manager.
Whoa.
And she told me that she was going to pick up food for Lil Baby and 42. They were hanging out apparently in Buckhead.
Oh.
And I was like, bullshit, I don't believe you. And then she proceeded to show me several photographs of them hanging out and showed me her contacts, which had several rappers in them. And she looked like she was in a rapper posse. I mean, she was flexing. She was blinged up and she was just picking up to go order. And it was kind of slow. So I was just like, what you doing tonight? She's just trying to shoot the shit with the customers. And she was like, well, hanging out with some rappers. And I was like, proceed to explain more.
Please.
Please. Please say more words.
Flood.
So
like real rappers or like SoundCloud rappers, like,
my neighbor who thinks he's a rapper, like
in the shower for 20 minutes.
Yeah. But anyway, Tanner, go ahead.
That's all.
Oh, that's it.
Did. Yep. 42
Doug.
Matt.
Yeah, I got more of a Logan speed pick. Kacey Musgraves, she got divorced. Ooh. So she's probably going to put out some heat because of that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Who was she married to?
Rustin Kelly.
Oh yeah. I remember this. I remember seeing this on Twitter. Kacey Musgraves?
No, her dude.
He's another country guy.
Griffin forgets. Griffin might not remember, but we saw Kacey Musgraves live.
Yeah, I do remember.
Back when she was not famous, she was touring with Kenny Chesney, and it was she put out her
first album.
Yeah, I forget what it was called, but I can picture the album art.
It was a
same trailer, different park.
I remember it.
That's probably it.
You are talking to a certified stan, so you just throw it up to me, and I'll knock that shit down.
Slam dunk it. What was the slam dunk song on that album?
Follow Your Arrow or Merry
Go Round. That's it. I was just gonna say. I thought it was gonna be Follow Your Rainbow, but isn't Rainbow a song on the new on Golden Hour?
It's on Golden Hour. Yeah. Okay. Cool.
Gotcha. So, yeah, that's a good pick.
Yeah, but it's definitely like coming. She apparently dropped like a little bit of it on a podcast, not this one, unfortunately. But yeah, Logan, what's that? What's your for number four?
Casey Musgraves isn't doing exclusives with the Binge Boys yet.
Yet.
Hey, we'll figure it out.
Number four for me is something that has been teased for a while. It might be mainstream. It is. It's Certified Lover Boy by Drake. He's been teasing that album for the last year and a half now, and just waiting to see what he's been putting out. Ooh, Certified Sneeze or Cough by Matt there.
Cough.
I'm just waiting to see what he puts out. Every Drake album is just like 15 songs of nothing, but there's always at least one banger that gets played all summer.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm just waiting for that banger because I'm starting to get over Wants and Needs, like, with him and Lil Baby. That song is flame.
It is.
But I'm starting to get over it. So I need something new from Drake to keep me over for the next like 5 months. Just one song. Just give me one song. But really just drop the album. Certified Lover Boy. Talk about an album name. Certified Lover Boy.
I don't like
it. But anyway, that's who I got. Griffin, who's your number four?
Oh, my number four is Baby Smooth. He's a relatively new rapper.
You're like, Matt's just going to be like, who the fuck are these people that your brother
is? Yeah. All I listen to is basically hip hop and maybe some dude that it's just hip hop.
Griffin listens to hip hop, but he listens to like underground hip hop that nobody's ever heard of. But Griffin has a really good track record of listening to nobodies and then telling me, oh, they're going to be famous. And then they end up being famous.
What's this dude?
Yeah, I do.
Have
yeah.
You wearing like a
just a few
freaking Toronto few. Blue Jay. His deal. Whatever. All right,
Tanner.
Well, did you look up Baby Smooth?
Yes.
I bet you didn't smell it. Right? It's weird as shit. Yeah, but yeah, he's really he's a good rapper. You listen to a few of his songs. He's got a pretty good melody. Sure. I want him to drop some more shit. It's pretty good, man. There's nothing really good coming out with rap, so I like listening to people that like are inventing shit and not just repeating like some of the other mainstream rappers are kind of just repeating and trying to make shit sound good even though it doesn't really sound good. Oh, I don't know.
Fair.
That's just me. But Tanner, you're fourth?
Guy that Griffin showed me, his name is Lil Juice and he's good.
Sheesh.
Oh yeah, I want to hear some good shit from him.
I have heard of Lil Juice.
he did. You know, have you heard that Tate Keith? You heard that tag, right?
Like, Tate Keith, fuck.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that, yeah.
That's him. That's his voice. That's, what? That's yeah. Lil Juice. Yeah.
Oh,
that's why.
Yeah, Lil Juice did that too.
Wow. Yeah. Tate Keith could have hired anybody, but he hired Lil Juice.
Yeah, no, Lil Juice is fire though.
It's not like Young Metro that or Metro Boomin that's got Future's voice with his tagline. This guy got Lil Juice.
Hey, but Lil Juice is dropping fire, dude. It's good.
Okay, I'll look up Lil Juice. I'll look up Lil Juice.
You'll figure it out, and so will the rest of the world. But Matt, what's your fourth?
My fourth is Lizzo. She drops bangers, just like
I love Lizzo.
Drake. She had like. She dropped like 5 singles off her last album that was like heat, and she's just been like, to my knowledge, not really doing much. She's
it's a vibe.
Pump some more out there.
You like Lizzo, Griffin?
Yeah, oh yeah,
that's it.
Kennedy showed me
Lizzo. I did not see that one coming.
It's decent, man. I'm not gonna lie,
dude. It's mad decent.
It is. If that song that she, what was the song? That bitch. DNA test. What was the song actually called?
I'm just
picturing hurts. Griffin singing along to that when that comes on in the morning when he's getting ready.
That's not a good one though.
It's just the one that's overplayed.
No, oh, totally.
Yeah,
not good.
Not juice.
It's good. Juice it's just overplayed.
Shit. Yeah, yeah.
She needs to get a little juice featured on her album.
That would be a mess.
Sheesh.
All right, Logan. What you got in the middle?
Oh, I got Lil Keed. I'm just kidding.
Oh, dude.
I am just kidding.
That's a pretty good one.
Although Lil Keed is a real artist. I put Travis Scott. Astroworld was the last big thing, unless I'm forgetting something. I think Astroworld was the last thing he really did of noteworthy.
I don't know what to do. That one with like Jack.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I need a new project. I need a Huncho Jack Huncho sequel Huncho album.
Jack.
I need good. I need another one of those. I need something new Rodeo. From Travis. But he's one of those guys that works on an album for 6 years and doesn't put anything out. So
respect.
Better than him putting something out every 2 weeks. I'd rather him take a lot longer with his craft. So
or drop Culture when it was not needed and have everyone not listen to it at all.
Culture 3?
Yeah.
Exactly. Culture 1 is a banger.
Culture 1 was a banger because nobody expected it and nobody was like...
Yeah, Culture 1 is great.
But, nobody was holding it to a standard.
Oh, he did do that little tape with those guys from his label. The album that had Out West on it, the Jack Boys thing.
Take it out with.
Yep, that's Jack. Yeah, that was a good one. It's a banger.
A good song. But yeah, that's Travi. I love there's very few things in music that get me more hype than when you hear like Travis like humming on a beat before he comes in. It's like, oh, it's like how I feel about Kid Cudi when Kid Cudi's in the background of a song, just like humming. And it's like, okay, let's go. But anyway, yeah, that's who I got at number three. Griffin, who's your number three?
It's Lil Juice. He stole mine, but
I did.
Yeah, he stole it. But yeah, he's a good artist, upcoming artist. I think he's good. Listen, if you like rap like we do.
Word.
So my third.
No, right? Yeah, third. Okay, yeah.
I'd like to hear from Playboi Carti again.
Oh, wow.
Better.
Way better.
Yes.
Again,
hold him to the 2016 standard.
Dropped an album last year.
Dial it standard.
Dial it back, dumbass. Right? God. It's gross. His music now is kind of...
It's like, cringe.
It's worse.
A little.
I mean, but it's kind of the same stuff, and we're just kind of just getting... I don't know.
Maybe it's just moving out.
Probably. Maybe
he's probably just... Yeah, I don't know.
Someone that goes...
Yeah,
is bound to...
Yep. Totally die out at one point. Like... Noting a few of their other rappers like Lil Wayne, he was high pitched and annoying. He slowly died out, even though he was talking words. But this guy, you can't even hear what the hell he's saying. Somebody's gonna get annoyed after a while.
Well, Matt, what's your three?
My number three, just since he's not very reliable, but like always down to drop something new, Frank Ocean.
Love Frank Ocean.
He's down to put on some Frank Ocean. Just cry. I love crying to Frank Ocean.
Yeah, he did. Frank Ocean's really good. I'd love to hear something new from him too.
You need to listen to Frank Ocean and Odd Future stuff. Their stuff is good. It's so good. But Tyler the Creator and Frank Ocean together, I think it's good.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Yeah.
I think sounds good. Good little mix up there.
Griffin be like burying his music reputation with Matt, and then he says like Frank Ocean and Tyler the Creator, and Matt's like, all right, Griffin can't totally disappoint me.
Dude, I used to be over Tyler the Creator, dude. Oh, goodness. Great artist. Creative artist. Totally.
Real good. Big fan.
I think this is number two.
This is number two.
Up out there.
My number two is an odd one. It's one that nobody saw coming. The artist's name is Tyler Hubbard. So recently, Brian Kelly put out the banger of the year, Sunshine State of Mind. Yeah. Tyler Hubbard is the other half of Florida Georgia Line with Brian Kelly. Brian Kelly put out still what is probably going to be my favorite album of the year. And a lot of people are waiting for what Tyler is going to put out in response to Brian's solo project that was very well received. So I'm just waiting to see what Tyler does. That's it. That's really it. I'm curious. Brian went with a total beach, Kenny Chesney, Jimmy Buffett vibe feel. So I'm curious to see what Tyler does in response. That's it. That's really it. Who would have thought that one of the Florida Georgia Line guys breaking off and doing his own thing had been better than the last three Florida Georgia Line albums combined? So we'll see what the other one does. Who knows? It could be like, when I talk about you a few weeks ago, how like the Migos all put out solo albums and they were all really good.
Yeah, and then like, they got together and it just wasn't.
And then Culture 3 came out and it was like, these guys should have just stayed solo.
Right. This wasn't that good.
So, yeah, we'll see what happens. If not, I don't know if he's going to release something on his own. I'm sure he is now that the success of Brian's album did really well. So we'll see. That's my number two. Griffin, who is your number two?
My number two, actually, nobody's really talking about him right now. 21 Savage. Where the hell is he?
Not in England.
He's here, I mean, but he's just living it up. Apparently, he hasn't dropped something in over a year.
Savage Mode 2.
Mode 2 with Morgan Freeman.
Yeah, that was like last year.
Yeah, that
wasn't that good.
It was not that good. I want to hold him back to his old standard.
Renin.
Where he was good.
That song goes.
Like, let's talk about I Am I was fire.
I Am Greater
Without
Than I Was.
Warning was fire. It's an album was good. Savage Mode fire. Slaughter King fire. Where this he isn't doing shit right now. And I want to see something.
He put out I'm gonna make a spin like a spiral.
Oh yeah, that was,
that was cheesy from the Saw movie.
That was cheesy.
Yeah, that was just Warner Brothers saying, "Hey, you want to make a lot of money by doing nothing? Make a rap song for our Saw movie."
No, but if someone heard that on the radio and didn't see Spiral, that maybe you'd like it.
I liked it.
But after the scene in the movie, I was like, "Okay, middle fingers. I don't want to hear you."
I'm gonna let him spin like a spiral.
That's my take on 21 Savage. Tanner, who's your second?
My second is gonna be I want to hear from Uzi.
Uzi.
Uzi. Uzi.
He's fire.
Yeah.
He's always been fire. That's one artist that I also listened to when he was underground completely, and he blew the hell up. I knew he was going to be good.
He is good.
It was Love.
Love is Rage.
No.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, that's it. Because Love is Rage 2 was out last year.
It was the one where, him and his girlfriend, he was with his girlfriend at the time.
Yeah.
With her on the top of that thing.
She was on
her.
The top of the track.
Yeah.
Like he was. Did you see that thing on Instagram? Yeah.
This album.
Yeah, that one.
Oh, that's a good one.
Hunting along.
Yeah. I mean, what?
I love that thing he put out with Future was trash.
Dude, you need to listen to Off White by Lil Uzi.
Off White. All right.
Papa Zan.
Off White. This
night.
Got bait.
All right.
Matt. Anyway, we're losing Matt.
Matt's about to die.
Matt's about to fall down.
Matt's just like. All right. Matt, you're number
one
two.
One of my favorite sort of pop punk thing. Yeah. They officially broke up, but they're touring back together, and that is Motion City Soundtrack. I feel like I'm outvoted so none of you probably heard of them, so we can just move on.
I've heard of them.
Number one.
I haven't.
Yeah. For your albums, yeah.
Yeah, that talk about something that just disappeared from my to-do list was the album rankings. Remember when I did that like every day, like four a day?
The album? Oh, yeah. You used to be all over that.
Dude, that
shit.
Was a lot.
I think I just burnt myself out, to be honest.
You did. And music, they weren't really coming out with as much.
You got to understand.
Right? Yeah, you're right.
Right? Or no?
Yeah.
Music has gone down, in my opinion.
Classic shit, yeah.
Podcasts are where it's at.
Yes, podcasting is where it's at.
But either way, my number one, the number one artist that we haven't heard shit from in years that needs to drop something ASAP is Kendrick Lamar.
Oh
where is he?
Hasn't dropped anything since Damn. He did the Black Panther soundtrack in 2018.
Still,
where is Kendrick Lamar? Yeah. He was absent during BLM. He was absent during the election. He was absent during COVID. You got to think he's cooking something real nice.
Yeah, I'll disclose this. I had someone else, but I'm throwing it out. My number one is also Kendrick Lamar. He needs to drop that.
Who was your number one originally?
Oh, it was just very. Vampire Weekend. I've had like two of their albums just like on a constant cycle, but that's just the wrong answer. It's not them. It's Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah, he's been absent since Damn. If you don't want to count the Black Panther soundtrack as a Kendrick thing, although it was produced.
What was like the untitled? I mean, that is not really like a real album.
Yeah, I forget when that came out, but. But yeah, we need something where it is heavily advertised, heavily featured. We need more Kendrick Lamar, but you got to think it's coming soon. Like where's the dude been? What's he been doing? He's another one of those artists that only drops like every 2 or 3 years. So, or in this case, like it feels like it's been 4 years.
I mean, damn, is it 6 years ago? I feel like
shit. That's crazy. That's absolutely crazy to hear that. Cool. DNA is one of my favorite rap songs of all time.
That's really
DNA
really
is amazing.
Is an amazing song,
and that so is fire.
So is a lot of those other songs on that album that not a lot of people hear. Like Love is a really good one too.
Love is really good.
He's got a masterpieces on there.
You're right. It was 2017. So yeah, 4 years. My bad.
I want to be with you. Yeah, I want to be with. You know who else hasn't dropped in a long time?
Who?
Schoolboy Q. Me and Griffin were just talking about.
Top yeah, that's my number one.
It is?
Yeah.
Oh, whoops.
Well, how about that transition?
Oh, well, I mean,
yeah. Jeez.
Yeah, my number one, Schoolboy. Where the f*** is this nerd? He's just partying with college girls.
He is like a nerd. Is. Isn't he a nerd?
He's no. like, yeah, he's like one of these like artists.
He? Yeah, he's like a real smart kid. Like, actually, I remember reading something a while back about that.
Cool. Well, anyways, where the hell is he? Hopefully he's not on some drugs. Hopefully he's just
cooking.
Yeah, hopefully he's cooking. Yeah. Hopefully he gets some good album with some features so he can get in the spotlight again. He's just a good artist, in my opinion. I've loved him ever since Collard Greens right there.
So. Oh, Collard Greens.
Chitty Ching Ching could buy everything. It's so fire. But yeah, Kendra, I mean... Damn.
Oh,
Schoolboy.
Yeah.
Tanner?
21 Savage.
Really?
Yep. I want something really good from him. It's been a while that I didn't really like the last one. So
terrible.
I've listened to one song on it. No, two.
I wasn't interested.
Right now was all right.
I love Mr. Right Now.
That was a good one.
Yeah.
So take your phone off. Take your clothes off. I'm a sad, but I'll fuck up to a slow song.
And the lights down. Play the pipe out.
Anybody listening to this is getting cancer.
Yeah, we're singing the worst part.
Jeez, I'm sorry.
That's the top five, and that's this episode of Binge Boys.
Yeah, that was fun.
That was a fun one.
That's a good one.
That was a good one. That's one for the ages.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Yeah, you're thanks welcome. for coming on and talking Suicide Squad with us.
What? Damn.
Of course. That was fun.
You want to plug yourself or tell the people what they can do?
Yeah, you can follow me at Dern Alliance. It's DERNALLIANCE on Instagram. Yeah.
And
give me a follow. We got updates for my own podcast. We got updates for this podcast. We got updates for basically everything I'm affiliated with and enjoy doing, listening to, and playing.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
How about that?
Welcome to my life, bitches.
what Derns come out on Fridays?
Yeah, correct. We had the first one come out on a Tuesday, but we're going to switch to Friday because Friday's just a vibe. Right? Friday's a great day, and I want everybody to affiliate that day with my podcast.
Wow.
Well said.
Like I said at the top, follow us on Instagram. That's the biggest thing we ask from you. Leave a rating and review too. That's also really requested. We'd love that. And just be on the lookout. The year is not over. We've still got movies. Things are coming out. We are ready. We are ready for stuff.
Ready to binge.
Think this weekend I'm going to find my way to the theater. If you guys don't, I won't hate you for it. But I think I'm going to find my way to the theater to see Free Guy, the Ryan Reynolds movie.
I want to see that too.
Okay. You want to see that too?
Yeah.
Oh, I saw a trailer for that, bro.
Water or Clear Water, that one.
Catherine and I might catch that at some point too.
Yeah. Let me go to that one. Let's go to us three to the
Free Guy.
Guy.
That looks hilarious.
That looks like a good one.
Yeah. If you want to, we can do that.
That's a good one.
I'm trying to go Thursday night.
But yeah.
Nope. I won't unless it's after 10:30
p.m.
What's our plans on the podcast?
Yeah, nobody's making movie plans on the pod.
Thanks for listening. Yeah, if you're listening right now, you're for real, man. That's big. That's big shout.
Shout out to our women. And even then, Catherine probably turned this off 20 minutes in. She's probably not listening to it at all, considering the fact that she's on the couch grading right now. So she'd basically just listen to it live.
Oh, yeah. That's good shit. That's good to digest.
All right, everybody.
Good seeing you, Matt.
We'll catch everybody on the flip side. See you next time.
Catch you on the flippity flip.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.